Hi, this is Gary with Mac using video special effects in iMovie. So we're looking at iMovie 10 here, and we're going to look at video special effects. I've got a simple project here with a bunch of different clips in the project. We're going to look at how we can apply a special effect to one of these clips. So with one of these clips selected, the first thing I want to do is hit the Enhance button and watch closely what happens in the preview window here. You can see that adjustments have been made to basically automatically enhance the video quality. So it does a variety of different things. And if you've shot your video on say a camera phone or just a typical point and shoot camera and you think that maybe the quality could use a little bit of a boost, you might want to try the Enhance function here and see what it comes up with. If you don't like it, you could always just click it again and turn it back off. Now, otherwise you can hit the Adjust button here, and now we have a variety of different things that we can do with each clip. For instance, we can click on color balance here and we could do a bunch of different things to adjust the color. You can use auto, for instance. Anything you do here, you can just use Command Z to undo. And we also have color adjustments here, which give you a whole wide variety of things that you can do with the video. You can use all of these to adjust the color in various different ways, creating a variety of different effects if you want. Now we can jump right to the special effects right here by clicking on this icon, and we have a set of video effects. I'll click there and we get to choose which video effect we want. You can see there's a whole variety of different things here. For instance, film grain's a very popular one, dreamlike quality right there, romantic, heat wave. There's a whole bunch of different things that you could do here depending upon what you want and what video you've currently got there. So let's look at aged film here. We'll select that, and we could see that there are going to be streaks now in the film. Might be hard for you to see here in the tutorial, but there's some streaks coming up and down. It's kind of darkened it and created this kind of aged film look to the video. Anytime you want to remove an effect, you can return here to the effects and just simply select none, and it will remove whatever effect you've applied before. Now if you apply an effect to a clip, like let's apply that this old world effect here, and you want to then apply it to another clip, one of the things that you can do is you can select it here, you can copy, and then if you go to another clip here, you can then go edit, and instead of paste you can do paste adjustments, and one of the adjustments you can paste is video effect, or you can do all. So if you've done some color adjustments and you've video effect and things like that, you can do all. Otherwise you can just paste the video effect in here, and you can see that now the old world video effect is now applied to this clip here as well as it is applied to the one before. It'll take it a second here for it to render it to the preview area. Now there's some other effects that aren't found here, so we'll go to the menus to find them, and you can do things like add a flash and hold frame. So notice where the playhead is in the middle of the last clip there. I'm going to select this, and you see what's going to happen. It's going to break it up into parts here. I've got the first part, which is normal, and then right where I had the playback head before, you could see it. Now there's a flash and then a freeze, and then it's going to apply this kind of Ken Burns effect right here, and then it'll continue afterwards. So if I play this back, it'll look like this. Maybe not that interesting with a waterfall, but say with filming somebody playing sports or something like that, it may create a little bit of a dramatic effect. And we also have a slow motion effect. So where I've got it selected here, I can start to apply the slow motion, modify slow motion, and let's do it down to 25% right there. And you can see now this clip here is now going to play at a much slower rate, and I can make adjustments to it by double clicking on a little turtle there, and I could set it to a different speed. You can see the length of the clip of course will change. I can even have it sped up to be much faster. I can set it to a custom amount as well, and you can see I can even then reverse the clip here. The modify menu actually has shortcuts to all of those here. You see fast forward, instant replay. It all brings up basically the same set of controls, and I can of course use the reset here to reset that clip back to how it was before. You have a few more things in the Modify menu you may want to check out. For instance, you have Fade To. You can have the video right where the playback hit is fade to black and white, sepia, or dream. So for instance, fade to dream, and you can see it splits it here. And now when I run it, it looks normal, or actually has the effect applied before, and then it goes to a more dreamlike state there with the transition in between. We can undo that. We also have add freeze frame. So right where that spot is there, I can set it to add one. You can see it's like the flash to freeze frame, but it's without any special transition. However, notice since there are black bars there, you can now set your own transition. So you could put your own transition in there and then have another transition again at the end before it resumes normal playback.